Radio, where we've got the best music from anywhere in the world. It's actually really crazy if you think about it. How can we afford it? Anyway, we have a lot of great music for you coming up in between the commercials.
rise up. Mic test, 1, 2, 3. Okay. I can hear myself now. You can still kind of hear me? Okay. Very strange. Should be there. Let's see if it hurts. If we can lower the volume of the radio even further. Okay, in the last episode, I installed a new tramline in this area, in Elk Square and Brook Park. Issue here is, I have a ton of passengers waiting and lots of traffic issues. Now, let's go and see if we can go fix that. All the streets are red. Yeah, 700 passengers waiting. And then the stops after that are getting better. Maybe it just needs a little bit more time after I installed the asymmetrical tram road and asymmetrical bicycle roads. So it's just basically the mic volume that is very hard for you guys to pick up on. Let me see what I can do. Okay, so here it's cranked up to the maximum.
Lights, camera. Another place or time, and there's no better place to watch than Drone Cinema. And no better time than the time it takes you to get from where you are to where we are. You'll break box office records of fun as you take a trip to Tinseltown, Movieville, USA. Action, cut, quiet on the set. Our theaters feature noise as we compare, guaranteeing the only thing you hear is the movie. That high-pitched shuttle drone is normal. It's the sound your ears hear when there's nothing for your ears to hear here. So come on down and enjoy the movies where everyone's a star.
Okay, it's still probably very bad. Okay, the traffic percentage is going up and then down again. It is slowly getting better. This junction seems to be clearing out. It looks like they need a path. So at the moment, this campus area only has two ways in. The one on this side and the one that I created yesterday is getting used to slightly better than before. Yeah, so this is mainly because of parking, I guess. Yeah, so this junction is almost cleared. What are these people waiting for? It's almost as if they need another another asymmetrical road here for the trams. Yeah, I'm not sure I have a road like that. Ideally, you want a road with a dedicated left and then the tram line in the middle going straight. Not sure there is a road like that. Okay. Let's go and try something. If I take this road, I'm going to upgrade this portion of it. Now let's check if it's the right way around or not. Of course not. And this particular road that I cannot change, so I will have to redraw it. And I will have to redraw it from the right side. So, if you want an asymmetrical road to go into the direction that you want, you have to draw it. You will have to draw the two lanes towards the junction or a point that you want to have them. By doing that, it will show up in the right direction. Now, here I want to do something. Maybe counterintuitive? Yeah, we'll set it up like this. So cars can go straight or left, and then cars can go right. That should, in theory, give us a little bit more leeway on traffic. Now the trend just needs to wait for the cars to pass. Yeah, so the bigger issue here is there is also a bus line coming through, and that bus will come in and then will cut across the tram or whatever other vehicle that needs to go straight on. Yeah, I know this texture says bus and taxi, but this is the only asymmetrical tram line I could find on the Steam Workshop right now. For the future, I might take this asset and convert it to something that I can use. But for now, this is what I have. Okay, so that traffic, yeah, it's still backing up. So, down to the real issue. And this is where another nice mod comes in. So, we have a ton of passengers here waiting for being transferred to their destinations. Yeah, over 1,000. And these trams are packed. At the moment there is 9 trams on this relatively short line, and they are already causing like traffic jams. So if we pick up this commuter destination mod, we can now see where they want to go. Okay, so in general they want to get to, let's say, the bigger squares on the screen. So they're taking the tram to get to something that is like a block away. I wonder if I would add tram line coming from here, going through here as a shortcut to get there. Because I have enough space for additional stops here. That might actually help. It will take some time, but... leave the path intact, I hope. Okay. Oh, there's a bloody... there's a pillar there. Let's see how bad it is. Ah, there's tons of space. Don't know why the game complained. Okay, now. Okay. So on these roads, I probably want to reserve parking as well. Ah, okay, so for the 1U, they're going in the wrong direction, but I can make it circle around. So I will make it come down here, go through this alley. Now let's think of where we want to bring it to. So coming up here. Up here over, and then this road ends in a bicycle and pedestrian lane. Okay. So up until here we can pass it through. Can we do this without losing houses? Yes, there we go. Crap. Okay. Yeah, it changed the... the orientation of my roads. Yeah, let me do this again. Yeah, that's what I should have done. Oh well, we'll get some new houses in. So this one, and now the stretch of road right here. Oh, we wanted something with parking. Neighborhood street. Okay, but now I do want it to be... okay. So we have the outgoing one. It will go all the way there, and then we're gonna turn it around and come down this road. I might want to upgrade it later to something with pedestrian, with bicycle lanes. But for now, it's gonna be just like this. We're going to go up, and then we join our tram network there. So now we only have to fix the very small stretch of lanes coming in. Now, where was that? Yeah. Put this down back to zero, and why is this not connecting? Oh, now it is. Okay. I need to come up and over by one. By the looks of it. Yep. One thing at a time. So now that's connected. And now just this stretch over here. No. The stretch over here needs to be upgraded. My neighborhood tram road. And then we're going to upgrade this section. Yeah, we're losing a ton of housing now. So, I'll create a new tram stop there. We'll have one right here, as it is very popular. We're coming over, and we'll have one here. How far is that away from the bus stop? It's okay, I hope. We're coming down here. I don't want to put one on this street per se, but we're gonna put one just over there, and then we're going to... I think I'm going to put this one on the inside. Yeah, I'm going to put it here. And then I'm going to circle back. So these stops are relatively close to each other, but I think it's gonna be okay. So this one will pull into the side street just to mirror the other ones. And then we can even have one here closer to that. We'll place one there. And then we'll bring it all the way to here in an outer loop type thing. And yes, I need to go and change the color.
You're listening to City's radio. As a radio host, I feel like I have the best job in the world. I get to sit in the
city. We can already see people starting to queue here. People can walk along the tram roads. It's perfectly fine. I need to do some decoration here, but so that's one of the original tram lines that was there. I don't know why it's not picking up the color automatically. So, a nice bluish color. Yeah, balloon ride just passed by. Where did it go? Oh, there it is. Getting some views from above. Going down. Yeah, let's see how many visitors I'm getting here. I'm getting no visitors whatsoever. Okay. Anyway, so there is some parking here for people to park. Yeah, this tram line feels crooked though. Okay, so passengers are queuing up. The problem is, these trams have to come from a long distance away. There's the first one. There it is. Where is he going? They're waiting right here. And there is the second one. So two of them made it through traffic. Perfectly fine. Yeah, so in some of my older builds, I used to build junctions like this to get across streets quite regularly. Then at some point I stopped building them. But recently, if you've seen any of Biffa's YouTube movies, in his city of something tea related, he actually had an area where he built a whole bunch of commercial stuff, and that was just like completely blocked down, nothing moved, like a good old grid that we can see here. Why are they waiting? Pedestrians. Okay, so because this is a high pedestrian area, it just gets clogged up and it asks for some attention because it is simply not moving. Hold on. So it's not moving because... Oh, my trams are getting stuck again. Where do all of these people want to go? Most of them want to turn left here. Ah. Okay, so this calls for an asymmetrical road. An asymmetrical trim road. Yeah. No, not that one. I hope it's drawn in the right way, or I will have to redo it. Yeah. Now look at these cars drive. So this is going to be a traditional left-hand turns go there, and then the right-hand turns stay with the tram line. That should fix all of this mess. It's still being funneled in. So I don't like this one being set up the way it is. We'll do it like this. And then that car gets a little crazy. So it's still not really moving. And the buses got clogged up so much that they were crossing a traffic jam. Yeah, truck delivery. Yeah, if you guys have any good suggestions or tips on some of the traffic issues or some of the areas that you see, feel free. I'll be happy to accommodate any suggestions or tips that you guys have. Yeah. Okay, I'll leave this alone for a little bit. Let's see if it calms down because of the small change that we made. Yeah, one thing I normally see is that you don't want to make like a ton of changes because you don't really see the effect of it. Yeah, so the change that we made with that extra route, well, we can clearly see. I think it just got more popular. Because now I have a ton of people there, and a ton of people there. Where are those trams? Ah, they're stuck again. But now on the next stretch. Oh man, I hate being one of these Sims that lives here. Yeah, of course, it's the wrong way round. Hold on. The wrong way round. So, turn around, and then continue. Yeah, we lost the houses. I really hate it when that happens. Still zoned as such. But we still have 60,000 population, so not too worried. I want the trams to be moving throughout the city nicely, as much as possible. Haha, tram traffic jam. Yeah, so this is another through movement that I need to think about. Because it's four lanes and hitting a six lane road. So that's a lot of lanes coming together, and you can already see it gets quite messy. And then this stretch itself is not long enough to hold all of the traffic. This stretch here is too short to hold the proper road going up and over. And this is the campus. Well, my campus is not doing so great. We're losing students. Yeah. This one is okay for now. Okay. Okay, so this soundtrack reminds me of Crusader Knights for some reason. Anyway, I'm not trying to make any advertisement for games or stuff like that. But this road, once the trams get past that initial hurdle, they should be fine. It is pretty much clear. It's just very busy in this first stretch. And by saying that, that traffic just disappeared. Irony. What is going on here? So the one-way system, then the tram tracks, and then it all hits here. What is going on? Because they can't move, because they want to move in here, and that doesn't move because they want to go there. The question is, where is it the bigger problem? These three junctions are pretty close together. So this particular road, they can only turn right, and because they want to get in, they want to turn. And this road can only go straight through, so they have to come through this street. They have to come through the street. There's no other option for them. Okay, half a car per time. I'm thinking asymmetrical bicycle lane, bicycle road. So I go to the bikes. I bring out this one. And I'm gonna say like this. And then I flip it around. And then this one will be like this. And now I need to fix the arrows. Dedicated turning lanes. There we go. Okay, so now we have dedicated turning lanes at the end of these ones. This almost feels too short. But I probably want this to have dedicated turning lanes coming out. Now it has only us coming in, and this is a very short section of road. I will flip it around just to confuse them and get rid of some of the cars. That will be fine. Now, this. Yeah, okay, I'll let him turn. I will not let him go across. If we're getting across, I will force them down this road and come around and do some whatever they want to do over there. It's not helping a lot, is it? I do want to turn there as well. There's a node. Why is there an additional node there? That's weird. But can it help me? Yeah, and I lost some housing. Let me... fix that. Oh, we can do something nice here, like a small park or something. Yeah, gridlock. You know what? I'll squeeze in two little parking areas. Yeah, the longer the game runs, coming in. Up over. That's because of this. Yeah, I'll do this one first. But now I need the asymmetrical one. Like this. Okay, so they're both marked for turning right. Take this one off and keep it for the trams only. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, it's a good point. The source seems to be in multiple places for this particular area. Tram seems to be congesting things up, and then things will just start go very bad from there. Things are moving right now, and it's getting better. And that just cleared up all of these issues.
How? It's not funny business, it's money business. You give your money to us and it will grow with interest. That's the plan, at least.
This is caused by cyclists.
Imagine planting a money tree in the ground and watering it. Hold on. Imagine if you had a money pet and you fed it more money, and after digesting it would okay. You want to go money fishing, so you use a little money to catch a big money. You know, just come in and talk to us. We have even more metaphors that allow us to avoid saying what we really do with your money. Banhammer Bank. Feed the money monster. This is City's Radio. I'm L. You know, like the letter.
Look, close to 80% and having only this known gridlock is not a bad situation. I've seen worse. It just needs to clear up. It just needs to whittle its ray around, and one little car at a time needs to start moving. Yeah. So, one of the things here is that there is realistic parking, or the IO for enhanced parking is turned on, meaning that I definitely did not provide enough parking places in this area for all of the cars. Hitting 80% is a great number. 81, it's going up, it's getting better. So the next thing that I probably want to do is extend this road across and then connecting it with the highway over here to relieve some of the pressure, because at the moment the only entrance into the city is this area here. It's highly utilized. It's optimized for flow. Yeah, we're getting there. It has all kind of nice features there. It is doing great with tunneling the flow. And then, so they can either go in here or go straight on through this nice long corridor, and this corridor actually carries across. So, and here it branches off, and it technically it doesn't go here, it turns left into this area here, and then it comes here at this junction. And then I probably want to make this a more sweeping turn and then have it continue all the way through. The other way that they can go is if they will come in, they will come through here. And then this is the other corridor that I have for through vehicles. And that ends up here. And it is busy. It is busy. But yeah. It feels so good to see that number in the 80% again. Yeah. So it pretty much serves the entire city, because there's no other input roads. Yeah, there are a few mods that are being used right here. So everything is green, everything is goo. So let's look at some of the import areas. So there is some train system coming in. Why are they flying? Yeah, this is a very steep area. I'm not sure I want to keep it like that. But it fits in nicely. And then we have the cargo barges as well. Let's see if it disappears. Fishery. Oh, what is this? Hold on. What are they complaining about? Where is this one going? Yeah, okay, so there is fishing rods set here, but for some reason they're not working. Okay, well, for the ones that actually watched this this episode, thank you so far. I will be back later today. I just need to go off and do some stuff right now that prevents me from actively streaming. I'll leave the stream on a little bit, so you can actually see some of the views, but yeah, I'll be back with the next episode. And so in the next episode I will be planning to make this connection to the highway here, so to get more people in and maybe build up another area here around the train station so it gets even more utilized. Yeah, this is where the two tram stations meet up. So yeah, I also need to do some decorations around some of these areas because they are pretty barren, they're pretty empty, they're like not what I want to see. Yeah, so this got completely rebuilt after the fire it had. Yeah, looking good and great so far. The tram pass over. Weird road connections. Oh man, so what I was set out to do still didn't really happen. We still have like a ton of people here. There we go. So we only halved the amount of people there. Not entirely happy. See if they're all bunched up. No, they're not. Yeah, guys. So I'll be leaving it for now, and yeah. That's gonna be it for now. I will be making a better purchase of a mic soon, so stay tuned for that. I'll let you guys know when that happens. Yep. Thank you very much.